We are back again for another spoilers video for episode 23, which is March of the Zombies 2. As you know, it's a continuation from the last episode, as we didn't really get through all the zombies quite yet. As we saw at the end of the episode, we had Toshiro Hitsugaya, and everyone was kind of shook about it, including the Irankars, Mayuri, Andikaku, and Yumachika. And we will be continuing going from that, which, to be fair, is probably going to be one of my favorites, because in the manga, when I was reviewing it, I really enjoyed this bout. But before we get into the synopsis, hit that like, that subscribe, and let's get into it, shall we? So, you know, the deal, we talk about the synopsis and the translations is a bit iffy, so we'll just go with the flow. Ikaku and Yumachika fight against the zombies manipulated by Giselle, even with the help of the Irankars. However, Giselle has prepared Hitsugaya, the captain of the 10th squad, as their next pawn. The zombified Hitsugaya's relentless attacks leave Ikaku and the others in a state of collapse. Hitsugaya also slashes at Mayuri, but Mayuri is undeterred and says he has a medicine he wants to try out. Meanwhile, Hisaige comes to Byakuya, who was fighting Robert and his men, and swings his sword at him. But who was at the end of Hisage's sword? Now, that's going to sound like a little bit of bumbo jumbo, so let me try and, I guess, translate it myself a little bit differently. It's basically, towards the end, it's saying that Hisage comes to Byakuya in an attempt to, quote-unquote, help him out, as Byakuya was fighting Robert and his men, but Hisage swings his sword at Byakuya, and then it goes to say who was at the end of Hisage's sword, meaning what was the meaning behind Hisage swinging at Byakuya. So, we're going to get into that right now. So, as we go through these pictures, we first see Hisagi, and this is probably in relation to what we just talked about in regards to probably seeing that scene. Now, at this point, if you've read the manga, we are going to be going into spoiler territory. This is, of course, where Hisage is potentially already hit at this point, or just before he's hit with the ability of love, which of course we'll elaborate on shortly. Because next one, we have a picture of Byakuya, and this is probably leading off from what we had on the last episode, where Byakuya is probably looking at Robert with Nananana and Candice, probably. There might be more, but this is probably where Hisage comes in to potentially help Byakuya. And I'm hoping there's a little bit of back and forth with, of course, Byakuya versus Robert versus the other Stone Ritters before we get into the Hisage stuff, because, again, I really want to see, like, big matchups, I guess you could say. Not one-on-one fights, but, you know, group fights, because I do think Byakuya does deserve it at this point. Next screenshot, we get Yumachika versus Toshiro, and, of course, this is the only screenshot of Toshiro we have within this spoiler images. And, yeah, as I said, I can't really wait to see what this is going to look like in the anime, because it was one of my favorite fights within the manga itself. I do think, you know, as we explain further on, that when the episode does come out, that Toshiro is a prodigy. He's a strong captain. The only thing holding Toshiro back is ultimately his emotion. So when you're a zombie and that emotion has been taken care of, you've got nothing but a killing machine from Toshiro when it comes to agility, versatility, not worrying about how strong his Bankai or Shikai is going to be because he's not caring about those around him. So this is an unfiltered, unadulterated Toshiro that's just going to go absolutely messy. And he does. As it says in the synopsis, he absolutely bodies Ikaku, bodies Yumachika, and also the Irankar, and then goes to Mayuri. So again, it's going to be really exciting. Again, he's fighting, I'm not going to say they're scrubs, but in comparison, you know, they might as well be, you know, they're not captain class. So when he goes up against Mayuri, I think Mayuri is, in this fight, you know, interesting to say the least. You know, this is where the famous Mayuri Deus Ex Machina comes in, because this, you know, this guy always has a plan for everything. But regardless of if Mayuri was also, like, kind of countering Hitsugaya within this episode, Toshiro, he makes some waves. I mean, there's one point where I think Mayuri blows off, like, Toshiro's kneecap, and he doesn't care. He's still going in for it. And then, of course, the next one we see Mayuri's face kind of looking relatively, I was going to say concerned, but at this point, like, the more that I look at it, going with the context that I have, is that he clearly is looking at it quite sadistically, if that's the correct word. And this is where, you know, in the spoilers notes here, it does say, like, that he wants to test a new drug out on Toshiro. So, again, how did you concoct this drug? How did you concoct the Pokeballs that collected Bambi's Reishi Balls or Reishi Explosions? How does he do this in such a quick amount of time? And to have, you know, one of these medicines, that's going to be... I would like to hope that there is more explanation within the anime. So I'm very excited to see this as well. And then, of course, at the very end, we have our new, not so new, but because we've seen him before, we have Pepe Wakabrata. And I've come to the conclusion that March of the Zombies is just not this mini arc or mini segment within the arc that I particularly like. Like, actually, like, thinking about it, March of the Zombies is, like, it's cool in concept. I think a lot of people enjoy it. I enjoy it. But I also don't like it because, one, Giselle, not for the reasons that you think, it's because of what, you know, Giselle does to Bambietta. But, so, I already don't like Giselle. But then you throw in Pepe, which is just a disgusting character. Look, whoever's on the staff, if you're watching this video, I don't know who has done the shot, but whoever has to draw Pepe's dick, you are like the MVP, because nobody should ever have to go through that. And I can't wait for my live reaction, because you were going to see this guy called Pepe. I'm assuming it's going to like cover everything this episode. If it goes on to the next episode, I'm going to be like kind of cringing. But I'm going to assume it's going to end with like Pepe like getting diffed. Like, hopefully, I'm really hoping. I don't need him past this episode. Preferably, I don't need him past a minute, you know, if at all. Like, if there's one thing the Thousand Year Blood War should be cutting, it's not Rukia's ass, it's Pepe. Well, maybe that's the point. It's supposed to make me feel that way and not like these characters. But still, scumbag character, and I hate him. I do think this episode's going to be a interesting and a good episode. I have, you know, not as strongly as episode 26, but I have heard things about this episode, which does sound quite exciting. You know, in terms of looking at the staff listing and what I've heard as well, it will probably have, you know, some good animation moments, I think, that people like to see in comparison to the other episodes. So I'm excited, and I'm very interested to see what those high animated segments are going to be. I do believe that there is going to be an extension with not an extension, but like maybe like a prolonged like scene or segment of a certain fight. I won't say which, just to not get anybody in trouble, but that should be good as well. Or maybe there's more extended parts, I don't know. All I know is that a fight's going to be extended quite slightly, or there's going to be more like kind of refinement, maybe. I don't know what the terminology I would choose, but regardless of what, there's going to be some extra teeny little bit of choreography in there, and I'm excited for it. So I really can't wait to see what Pierrot really cook up with this episode. And I hope it's in good production. I don't know anything besides just extra little tidbits here and there. But again, it should be a strong episode. That's what's important. It should be a strong episode. So, you know, keep your expectations wary, but, you know, go into this thinking it should be all right. It should be a good episode, you know, more so than other episodes, you know. Obviously, I wouldn't compare, but it's going to be a good one. It's going to be quite enjoyable. So, you know, fingers crossed for that. So, tell me your guys' thoughts in the comment section down below. Yeah, just I don't know what to say. Enjoy Pepe, everyone, because it's not going to be an enjoyable character to witness. So, hopefully he's gone. But with that being said, I'm going to catch you motherfuckers later. You guys, of course, have this one. I've been Hanson. And as always, people, peace out.